Hello everyone, my name is Manu Parimi and I'm an applications engineer at Plexim. I'd like to welcome you to this tutorial video on getting started with the STM32 Target Support Package. Before we begin, please make sure you have installed the latest version of either Plex Standalone or Plex Block Set. If you haven't installed Plex, please visit our website for support. Keep in mind that you need licenses to both Plex and Plex Coder. First, go to www.plexim.com using a web browser of your choice. Once you're there, hover your mouse over the download button and select the appropriate target support package from the drop-down menu. In this case, I'm selecting the STM32 support package. Click on the appropriate zip archive to download the file. I have downloaded the zip archive to my desktop. To install the Coder target support package, first, create a new folder at a location of your choice and rename it as Coder Targets. In this case, I have created it on my desktop. Next, extract the zip archive that you have downloaded and move the STM32 directory to the newly created Coder Targets folder. Note that all the target packages supported by the Plex Coder should be placed into the same folder. For example, to install the RTBox software or the TIC2000 TSP, these target support packages should be placed in the Coder Targets folder as well. It is recommended to also install the RTBox target support package at this point to access a wider variety of demo models. Now open Plex and click on Plex Preferences under the File menu. Here, you should see the Coder tab if you have installed the Plex license with Plex Coder. Choose the Coder Targets folder that you've created under the Target Support Packages path. You should see STM32 under Installed Targets. If you don't see the target support package show up at this point, please make sure that you pointed Plex to the parent directory of the folder named STM32. The package does not require any external tools because the application can be built directly using the ARM GCC tools and then flashed to the target via OpenOCD by default. Although optionally, the Segger jailing package can be used in the workflow, which can be downloaded and installed separately. The path to the installation should be entered here. You should now see the STM32 target support library added to your Plex library browser. There are two ways to deploy generated embedded code onto an STM32 microcontroller. The first is to build and program the MCU from Plex, and the second method is to generate code into an STM32 Cube IDE project to then build and program from there. In this video, we will build and program the MCU from Plex. If you are interested in generating code into an STM32 Cube IDE project from Plex, follow the link in the description below. Now let's look at how to deploy code directly from Plex to the STM32 microcontroller target. Once you have a model that you'd like to build onto your MCU, here I have a model to blink an LED for example, navigate to the Plex Coder Options window. From the General tab, choose the desired discretization step size and change the floating point format to float. Then, navigate to the Target tab. Select the target MCU. Here, I'm choosing STM32G4X since I'd like to deploy code onto a G474RE MCU. Modify these parameters for the clock frequency, step size tolerance, etc. And then choose the programming interface. There are two options available. The first option is OpenOCD. OpenOCD is the default configuration and is supported out of the box without the installation of any external tools. The Segger jailing programming interface is also supported by the STM32 target support package. The jailing package must be separately installed and the installation directory must be referenced in the Coder tab of the Plex Preferences dialog as shown earlier. For this model, I'll be choosing OpenOCD, which is the default programming interface. Then click on Build. The Plex Coder will automatically build the code, program the MCU, and start executing the generated code. In this case, the green LED on my G474RE board is blinking. This concludes the tutorial video on getting started with the STM32 target support package. For more videos and other information, please visit our website at www.plexim.com. Thank you for watching.